Hi everyone, welcome back to my YouTube channel, Salesforce Emily, where I talk about everything Salesforce and some adjacent stuff. Today I have a very special guest. I have Jeremy on. He is a Salesforce architect and I'm going to be, I guess, asking him some questions that you guys have asked me about the Salesforce platform and that you are curious about. Jeremy is also my husband. That's why I'm able to do this interview in person with all the sickness going around. So. Without further ado, I'll have Jeremy introduce himself.
Yeah, so my name is Jeremy Call. I'm a solutions architect for a consulting company. And what I do is, I guess just a high level of everything is sales lands the client. And so they're already interested. And then what I'm supposed to do is I meet with them. I discover exactly what they need to have done. So lots of discovery sessions. After discovery, I lead my team. So typically I have a developer that works for these customized projects. And then I also lead any other team members. And sometimes, depending on the scale of the project, I also kind of get my hands dirty and do the day-to-day development and configuration myself. So yeah, that's kind of just a high level of what I do.
That's great. A few questions that people had submitted is, how do you become a Salesforce architect?
Yeah, so to become a Salesforce architect, the key thing is to get really good at the Salesforce platform, to know it very, very well. So there are some certifications that are required to become what is called an application architect. And there are three or four different certifications. There's the Salesforce Administrator, there's a Platform App Builder, and then there is two other certifications, being Sharing and Visibility Architect and Data Architect. So those four are all part of the Salesforce Platform Architect. And so getting those is absolutely, I'd say, essential to being able to understand the platform, to be able to design enterprise-worthy solutions. And so that's great to get those, but I'd say the best thing is to just get hands-on experience. So when you are able to interface with clients, lead discovery sessions, and really understand all of their needs and what are best practices in the sales and service, different sections of Salesforce, and being able to be confident in leading and making that happen, not just only when you're talking with your clients, but also when you're setting your team up for success.
Can you kind of explain what discovery is? Because not everyone is in consulting, so they might not know what discovery really is. It might be different if you're an in-house architect versus a consultant.
Yeah, great question. So discovery in the sense, so in the consulting space typically, and maybe you're kind of a smaller team, or maybe you are kind of a bigger consultancy, so things are divided up a little bit more. But discovery is after a client has shown interest. Typically this is, and it should be done after the deal is closed. And then the sales process has already identified that what they're interested in is possible. Now the question is how these things should be executed and the specific configuration. So discovery is that process where you meet with the client and you help them discover all the little details. The kind of goal of discovery is kind of twofold. One is to you want to have the architecture for all the data and the system, automations, all that figured. And then you also want to set your team up for success by creating user stories and knowing how to execute on the project. So those are the kind of two main things that you want to get out of the discovery process.
So it's kind of like a forward-minded planning of the project.
Yeah, exactly.
What really drew you to become a Salesforce architect? Why did you want to do this rather than becoming a developer, or rather than doing just admin stuff?
Yeah. So I do get that question when I interview people. That is a question that I like to ask them, and I also get asked too. So when I first started Salesforce, I was thinking, oh, I'm going to be an administrator, and that's great. I mean, that's a challenge in and of itself. And then I realized once I started learning Salesforce, I kind of had, I experienced this frustration of, I want to make sure that what we're working on those projects are going to be successful. And the reason why I'm saying that is because I've been in organizations or worked on specific projects where I was able to identify, like, maybe this architecture isn't too sound, but I couldn't quite put my finger on it. And I can tell you it's really frustrating if you're working on a project that you know is probably not going to work out the best. So then I've learned a little bit more about being an architect. Like I mentioned, I started out kind of the administrative stuff, and then I realized, hey, this isn't too crazy. This isn't the hardest thing ever. So it sounds interesting, and I love creating, and so I just kept on moving forward, and I've really enjoyed just working with clients and making their vision come to light. So it's been a really iterative process, and I've liked where I've kind of landed right now, and I'm always growing.
Is being a Salesforce architect still your quote-unquote dream job? Is this still what you are liking, what you're still wanting to do for a while?
Yeah, great question. So I think I really do like it, and the reason that I do like being an architect, it really is the people that you work with. So if I've got, I'd say my biggest area that I need help with is on the development side. So the very, very kind of cutting edge code customizations. I think that being an architect is something that I really do love, and I see myself doing it for a lot longer. I'm not sure if I'll keep on doing this for the rest of my career, or we'll see, but it's something that I've kind of found my footing, and I think that it's much better actually than I was anticipating it to be. I'm really enjoying my team. I think we work together very, very well, and I'm also having really good clients. So yeah, so far so good.
What is your biggest pain point when it comes to being a Salesforce architect?
Yeah, so I think the biggest pain point that I do have is really found in the projects themselves. And typically the biggest pain points here with the project management, it's not internal, but it's the clients having everything that we need for the projects. So what that means is sometimes we just need to have a session in Discovery where we understand what their internal workflows are and their business processes, but maybe they're not available because their calendars are full, or maybe they haven't completely finalized the processes. So I'd say that's probably the biggest difficulty, is that the clients themselves don't know what they want. And even if you lead them through some really awesomely crafted questions, and even if sometimes you have everybody in the room, it might not be possible to figure out exactly what solution you should make. But if you've got good clients, and they are able to articulate roughly what you want, and you know, it's kind of an iterative process where they say some things where they might want, and knowing best practices will help you show those things. You can demo them and get feedback. So that's good, but if you don't know where to go or what to work on, or if they don't, so you can't figure it out, then you're in a rough spot for sure.
Who would you recommend a Salesforce architecture career to? Like, what are some of the qualities that you might look for in a Salesforce architect?
Yeah, so I think that in order to be a successful Salesforce architect, obviously you have to know the platform well, and everybody can learn the platform. So, well, I think that everybody, if they want to, can be a Salesforce architect. But in order to be set up for success, being able to communicate is extremely important. So that communication to be able to speak with clients, to be able to communicate the architecture and design to everybody that's working on the project is absolutely essential. So communication is probably the number one skill. Second is, I would say, project management. And you could go either way if this is actually super important or not. Ideally, you would have a rock solid project manager, and they would help you through the project. But it's also really good as an architect to understand the project process, because you'll be the face of the company or the face of yourself if you're designing solutions on your own. Kind of a like a consulting freelance type deal there. Being able to understand all the different stages in a project will really help when you are in meetings with clients. You can help guide the conversations to what's needed next.
Great. Is there anything else that you wanted to add or mention?
Just in general, I think that being a Salesforce architect should be kind of the goal of really everybody on the Salesforce platform. There is need for really specific specializations like marketing or maybe CPQ, or maybe you wouldn't need to have a holistic picture of kind of the whole entire Salesforce platform. But I do recommend that it just makes sense to be a better admin. A really great admin is an architect. And to be a great developer requires an understanding of what you can use natively in the platform. So being a good administrator also helps you be a developer. And now if you have a great architectural background, then if you want to be a developer, then that will help you architect better development solutions. So there's a lot of things that are really closely related, and they really help out. So I'd say just keep on learning, and maybe you'll figure out that architecture is something that you like and that you want to do. I only found that out myself because I got my feet wet and I really just found a liking for it. So I recommend just moving forward and always learning and progressing.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for being on the channel. I know that we've talked about having Jeremy on more regularly over here. So if you do want that, be sure to hit the like button and subscribe. If you are feeling generous and you want more content like this, I put out hopefully every Saturday a video that are interviews or talking about the Salesforce platform in general. So if you want more of that, be sure to comment down below. And if you have any other questions for Jeremy, comment down below and we can answer them again, because his office is just behind this wall. So it's pretty easy to get some questions out of him. So thank you so much, and we'll catch you guys in the next one.